First, if you comment on this video, please start your comments with my first name, James, or I will ignore and delete all your comments without reading them. Second, comment on the subject matter and do not call names to the speaker like Glenn as stupid, dumb, fat, terrorist, etc., or I will ignore, delete all your comments without reading them. Third and finally, you progressives and liberals listening now, I think you are the most hypocritical losers ever, and you pretend, all of you pretend to have virtues, morals, and principles. You're just a bunch of dope-smoking, low-life racist peddlers who will lie to everyone, including children they molest, like socialist pedophiles you are, with the excuse that the American health care will fix your socialist sexual abuse that progressives perpetrate. And you teachers that rape the Constitution day after day, you better hope all your progressives and liberals don't get screwed by your own system, lame asses. So remember, ignore these last comments if you are not a liberal or a crappy progressive of any party.
Well, up until this weekend, the president was just so smart and so cool. He was so perfect. It was impossible for any comedian to think of anything to make fun of him on. Will Ferrell, who impersonated President Bush on SNL, said about Obama, and I'm quoting, "We're going from a guy who just set it all up for comics to a guy who's just so politically savvy. He thinks so carefully before he speaks." You know, like the 57 state thing. "I had kind of the tail end of Clinton and then Bush. I mean, there was so much raw material. It's such a tough time out there now. Oh, I feel bad for the comedians." Absolutely nothing funny about the president of the United States. I think it's a first. We couldn't make fun of the teleprompter. Can't make fun of the ego? Nothing funny there? Well, apparently the rough time has come to an end. SNL did a skit where they hammered President Obama. What was it, however, that the president did to cause the floodgates to suddenly open? Did he look goofy, mistaking a window for a door when entering the Oval Office? No. I mean, he did do that, but the media ignored it. He gets a pass on that one, yet we all know about the Bush mistake in Beijing. Is he getting flack for seemingly every member of his administration being some sort of communist or 1960s radical that was blowing up buildings? No, no. What did he do? Take a look.
"Now, I just don't see why the right is so riled up. I mean, how do you think the left feels? They're the ones that should be mad. Now, I'm sure they thought I would have addressed at least one of the following things by now. Global warming? Nope. Immigration reform? Nope. Gays in the military? Nuh-uh. Limits on executive powers? Nope. Torture prosecutions? Nope. So please stop saying this country is on the road to socialism. If that were actually the case, I'd be making some real changes. Instead, it took me 4 months to pick out a dog. So all of you frothing Glenn Beck supporters, put away those tri-corner hats and those Photoshop pictures of me as the Joker. Because if I see any more of this hateful rhetoric, I'm going to have to take drastic action. Nah, not really."
All right, funny bit, but it's a shot across the bow from the left. They're annoyed. They're frustrated. They have full control in the House and the Senate. This is their big chance. They've been waiting 100 years for this. They can pass basically anything they want to pass. And what do they have to show for it so far? Not an awful lot. Maybe they sense the opportunity is slipping through their fingers. If conservative Democrats do lose many of their seats at the midterm, it will only make the progressive agenda even more difficult to ram it through. So they're going to, or at least I think, they are threatening the president to Sarah Palin him. Take him on. The left wants him to start passing this stuff before it's too late. If the concerns of the far left continue to go unanswered, well, they'll become even more frustrated. And let me ask you this. Who's more dangerous? The Tea Party moms and those violent conservative mobs who have been completely peaceful and respectful, or some far-left progressive who has already proven themselves to be violent revolutionaries? Do you remember the footage of the G20 protests? I contend it is the far-left extremist that is becoming more and more disappointed and dangerous at Obama's lack of progress, who pose more of a violent threat than the moms of America. But maybe that's just me. Next, we say goodbye to an old friend, We'll be right back.